house.
Michael.
And this is Steven.
And we're going to do a little mono scene for you tonight, so get ready. All we need is a suggestion of
something you don't want to find under your bed.
A monster.
A magazine. Okay, magazines. 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 Okay.
So right here, there's a large display of old collectible magazines.
And every one of the magazines is in a poly bag. And they have various gradings from mints to, there's even some on the bottoms and ones that are not in such great condition.
And over here, there's another display rack with all types of objects that are displayed on there. They're like store objects and plastic things, but they're all like blacked out. I can't tell what they are.
On each of the blacked out boxes is just like kind of an abbreviation for like the Star Wars and SW and then the year.
And then over here there's a red curtain that says, arcade. To a back room, there's a lot of like moaning sounds coming from.
Mm. And right here is the door, and it's got a poster of like a scantily clad kind of like superhero lady in latex.
And over the door, there's a pick me out sign that just says sniff.
and right here is a table with just like cards and comics and kind of like binders.
Yeah. Can I help you? Can I help you?
Sorry, man. I'm just in my zone. Was I?
Yeah, you were touching the cards.
Sorry. These are great. Where'd you get them, Tom?
I got them in a garage sale.
Really?
Yeah. Your mom was selling
them. That's why they look so great. Those are my baseball cards. I haven't looked at them in years anyway, so.
Your mom sold me my cards now. You can buy them, though. Everything's for sale here.
You know, I haven't played with those cards in years.
You play with cards, okay?
Right, now I know you're a serious collector. And you're doing great with this shop, by the way. This is phenomenal.
It's called Sniff.
Sniff? Wow. Wow, I can't really imagine why it's called that, but...
We got some scratch and sniff stuff. not everything here, but... This section is scratch and sniff.
Wow, the scratch and sniff section is incredible.
Yeah.
You come on.
Yeah. It's a dream.
Yeah, I mean, we can commit fun of you for this kind of stuff.
Why would you do that?
Oh, I don't know. This, back in the day, it seemed nerdy. You know.
Yeah. Quirky, yeah. It did, didn't it?
Yeah, you were great.
Yeah. You know why? Because while you guys were out playing football, driving cars and stuff, I was already ahead of the next trend. Scratches.
I wish that instead of playing football and banging chicks in high school, I was collecting scratch and sniff stickers. This is insane to regret not collecting.
say it, you know, you scratch the snake's
neck. Oh, no.
Yes. Tell you what, Rick, if you're not serious here, are you going to buy stuff? Because I'm going to be stopped if you're not serious. I got a lot of other customers back in the
room. You know, it's... I'm
Rick, why don't you come in?
I'm interested in buying my baseball cards back.
Okay.
I mean, what is it? How much?
For
a lot, yeah.
You would not believe how valuable these were and how, I would hate to say this, but your mom just does not know anything about baseball cards.
Oh.
So, you know, I could let you have like a pack of these. This would be, yeah. this is 20 bucks.
Yeah. Yeah, you got some of my favorite players in this pack.
Funny. Funny coincidence, maybe.
Okay, so how much?
Well, I just told you that one's 20.
20? Oh.
But the real mint stuff back here, real mint stuff that you kept, I mean, those, I don't know what you were doing with those. Like, the edges are all wrinkled, and then, like Don Madigan's, like, mustache is about rubbed off. I don't know what you were doing with those. But these over here, these are the good ones.
Okay.
This one's still got bubble gum in it. I don't even know why you.
You as a collector should understand that, right?
Yeah. You know why? You know why I laugh? Because it was the one right move you made. The one right move.
Well, hey, I'm glad I did something right by
$100, you want this one, it's got the bubble gum in it.
You know what, Tom, I'm not going to lie to you. I didn't come here to buy baseball cards.
I could see that. I could totally see that.
I came here to see what my life could have been like.
Pretty sweet.
Yeah.
You're not even in the back room yet.
I haven't even been in the back room.
No, you haven't.
I mean, I hear a lot of cool stuff coming from there.
To members only.
Oh, cool. Can I be a member?
Would you like a membership?
I would love to be a member.
Okay.
Okay.
What's it's the... that easy, actually.
Yeah. Yeah. Remember, I can come here. We can hang out regularly.
Well, I'm working right now.
Well, you know, whenever you get a break or something.
10 minutes.
You know.
Okay.
Right, just stand around pretending like I want to buy something.
Why are you pretending? Why don't you just buy some stuff here?
Okay, I'll buy some stuff. I'm
going to
buy some stuff.
Okay, what can I interest you in?
This is a baseball card. Just put
them on. I don't even believe you anymore. I don't even believe you. Why'd you really come in here, man?
Because I wanted to become part of the club, you know?
Club Snip.
Yeah, I wanted to be part of the club. Snip. The members only club. That's why.
Okay, now you remember. What, do you feel better? What?
Yeah.
Mission accomplished.
Well, I'm excited. Learn, you know, what it's like to be a member of this memorabilia store, Snip, and I'm excited, you know, to be part of the boys. Are there a lot of other members?
Boys. I think this is just a childhood kind of dream.
Oh, no.
This is for kids. These are toys here.
No,
this is all toys.
I didn't mean toys. Like that. I didn't mean like I think you're a child.
Man child.
I don't think you're like man child, like boys.
Oh my god.
No, that came out wrong. I didn't mean to say you play with boys. I'm sure you have plenty of grown friends
that are members here.
That are members of this club. Yeah. I'm sure I'm not the only member of that.
You're uncomfortable, aren't you? I can tell that. You're uncomfortable. Because when you saw this, and you saw what you missed out in high school, and you saw how maybe you treated me, you wanted to come here and possibly make it good.
Yeah. I'm uncomfortable because maybe you just remember all that horrible stuff I did to you, and you just wouldn't let it go, and you just wouldn't even let me be a member of the club, but you did! You did all I had to do was ask and you said yes!
It took a lot of therapy to get there, man. I don't know how much you know. And you know what the last part of the therapy was? who's buying your baseball cards from your mom. That was the last bit. And when I bought that, it was like buying your soul. I knew I had you. I knew I had every year, every dream you had as a boy were mine now. It was all mine. I possessed them. And you know what the other thing was?
Uh-huh.
I knew one day you'd walk into my store. You'd walk into Sniff. Yeah. You'd want to come around. You'd want to buy back your childhood. And I know then I had power. I know then that I... Why don't you sit down while I tell you that? Yeah. I had the power. And it's like I could either let you have your boyhood back, or I could just cast you out in the street. You know what? After talking with your mom, I decided I was going to let you become a member. Because, man, we all need our boyhoods. Even though we become them, we can't let go of that. That thing that it gives us pleasure. When you grow up, you don't lose that. It's always there. It's in Don Mattingly's mustache. It's in amazing year with the Cubs that he'll never have again. But you have it every year in these cards.
Take it.
And you have them.
And I have them.
Well, I want them back.
I'm going to sell them to you. So you realize how precious this moment is. Sure, we could do installments here. You need to come back every day, set a little bit part of your past free.
Okay, that actually seems reasonable. Something that I would do, that I want to do.
There you go. How's that feel?
Feels liberating. Feels like harkening back to my old days. I don't even know where my mom found me.
She found him under your bed next to your magazines. Two over here. I also have all your teenage nudie magazines. Yeah. I've got your whole life here, man.
You have all my nudie magazines?
Yeah, just all of them. Don Mattingly's in this one, and his mustache is rubbed off as well.
This is
collector's
item. Okay, well, there's my teenage years.
Come back tomorrow. You got something to live for now.
Yeah, I guess I do. I've got my next couple months planned out.
You're going to buy your life back one stroke at a time. One dollar at a time, whatever it takes.
Well, that's great, thanks. But do you have anything else for my past here? I mean, do you buy anything else to grab?
I did. I bought these socks and your old running shorts, but I can't sell these. Yeah, no one wants this. It came with everything else. It was only like a dollar, so I was like, why not? I like the box. I figured out.
Well, can I just add the shorts?
Yeah. Come back tomorrow.
And what are my baby clothes doing?
I was hoping that a lady would come in one day and maybe I could start a family.
Okay,
I hope it's a boy.
Okay.
I hope it's a boy. I'm sort of planning ahead, but it's a great onesie, and if anything, you could buy it back.
I don't need that.
You don't need it.
Okay,
well, here we go.
But thank you.
No problem. Maybe you come back into the members arcade and get you something new for the next part of your life.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I guess talking about all this my past, I'm even thinking of my future.
You got a big road ahead of you. You've been out there, you know, with a gun without ammo. Now you got it.
Yeah.
Tell you what, you want to work here? It's like
actually,
home, probably.
Actually, I am between jobs right now, so.
All right. Let's do the interview.
Okay. Doesn't this count?
This counts. You're hired. Three quarter forward! That was perfect.
another duo up, they may have to deal